Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman of the session. I just want to make one correction. I work, I'm a senior research associate with the Institute of Oriental Studies, not the Institute of World Economy and International Relations. That was my previous job, but that doesn't matter, actually. So, distinguished colleagues, delegates, and friends, it's a great honor for me and a great pleasure at the invitation of the top management of the IDSA Institute to make today a presentation on the subject of Russia's views on radical Islam threat in Central Asia. I will try to confine myself to 10-12 minutes as it was requested, and then if you have questions, I can gladly answer them regarding everything which is pertaining to Russia's views on the Central Asia. Just a reminder before I start my presentation, a reminder to you all that Russian President Vladimir Putin has just recently finalized his visit to three Central Asian republics, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan, and Tajikistan, and that gives me special theme for emphasizing my topic in my presentation. Thank you. So, today's post-Soviet Central Asian countries are facing problems caused by all security challenges and the emergence of completely new threats. These threats may hamper the future of secular statehoods in the region and present a serious obstacle to modernization of those countries. One of the major new threats, according to the Russian views, is the steadily growing presence of the Daesh, or ISIS, in Afghanistan, with possible penetration to Central Asia states. In fact, there are already facts which we have in Russia that some of the Daesh militants are already in several Central Asian states, including, first of all, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. A United Nations Security Council paper stated, Afghan security forces estimated in March 2015 that some 6,500 foreign terrorist fighters were active in this country. There were 200 fighters from the Islamic Movement of Uzbekistan, which later was renamed the Islamic Movement on Turkistan, or IMT, alone. According to the Russian General Staff estimations, if the Afghans are also counted, the total number of terrorist fighters in that country may amount to 50,000 militants. That estimates as of December 2016. What are the new threats posed for Central Asia by Daesh? I will just name three of them. In 2014-2016, Second Front emerged in the Middle East that rapidly gained a Central Asian dimension. This front is a new threat posed by so-called Islamic State or Daesh. The ISIS threat, just talking a little bit ahead, about forecasting the situation with Daesh in Central Asia, the ISIS threat has a very possible aggravation in 2017 and in the near future after the total defeat of Daesh in Syria and Iraq, which may be very plausible this course of events, keeping in mind the latest victories of Syrian army in Palmyra, retaking Palmyra, and also retaining the Aleppo, and the retaking by Iraqi army of the city of Mosul. So it might be very possible that Daesh will be finally defeated in Iraq and Syria. So after that, with all the credit to forecasting, I think that the most possible way of further expansion of the Daesh activities, terror activities, will be the moving of Daesh fighters or militants via the Afghan border, via the territory of Afghanistan, to the Central Asian republics. According to a number of authoritative estimates, as of 2016, 500 militants have arrived in Syria and Iraq from Uzbekistan, 360 from Turkmenistan, 350 from Kyrgyzstan, 250 from Kazakhstan, and 190 from Tajikistan, and according to the state Russian Federal Security Service, approximately 1,800 to 2,900 Daesh militants came from Russia. This is a very grave circumstances for forecasting the further movement of Daesh, including the movement of Daesh into the Central Asia. Specifically, Daesh has listed Central Asia and Afghanistan as Vilayat-e Khorasan. You know that. But what is very crucial in this, that as I have already said, the Daesh militants appear to be already in Central Asia. And they are actively penetrating Afghanistan at the same time, exploiting the split in the Taliban after the death of its leader, Mullah Omar, and actively using the flow of funds from the Middle East, from some Middle Eastern countries. According to Al Jazeera, Taliban militants are paid 10 times as much as ISIS mercenaries, $700 versus $70 per month. So this is the good incentive, according to Daesh leaders, for involving more militants from the Central Asian republics, as well as from Russia and other countries, to fight on the side of Daesh. And according to Valery Gerasimov, chief of the general staff of the Russian armed forces, about 2,000, 3,000 militants directly linked to ISIS were in Afghanistan in the fall of 2015. What are the ISIS terror activities in Central Asia and also the so-called Islamic movement of Uzbekistan, or IMU? There was a slight error. Instead of D, should be read M. A special threat to Central Asia also posed by the Islamic movement of Uzbekistan, historically the most dangerous terrorist movement in the region and formerly part of Al-Qaeda, which has joined Daesh some years ago. Also, according to Russian views, ISIS is already engaged in subversive activities in Central Asian hinterland. Kyrgyz and Tajik experts report that ISIS has allocated $70 million for subversion in the region. That also poses the gravest concern for Russia and for our friends in the region about the terror activities of the Daesh. What are the main factors contributing to instability of Central Asian states? I will just name some of them. Large-scale drug trafficking along the northern transportation route from Afghanistan to Russia. There is some figures I will just shortly give you that about $2 billion spent for drug trafficking. This estimates as of December 2015, according to the Russian Committee for Fighting the Drug Trafficking. This drug trafficking is going from Afghanistan through the territory of Central Asia onwards to Russia, to the Central Asia, and later on and further on to the Western Europe. But the main consumer of these drugs, the Central Asian states and some youths in Russian Federation. Clashing interests of powers involved in the new great game for influence in Central Asia, Russia, the United States, China, the European Union, and some Islamic countries. First of all, I mean the Islamic countries from the Persian Gulf, which may aggravate security threats or at best reduce to naught their support for regional countries encountering various challenges. Now I'm ready to give you just my own possible scenario of further ISIS expansion. I have already said a little bit about that, but I will repeat at large. The most plausible scenario of further ISIS expansion after its defeat in Syria Iraq and Libya is Daesh penetration and terror activities in Central Asia, which pose a very serious threat to Russia's national security interests. Not only Russia's national security interests. I think that for Central Asian republics as well, and for other countries, for China, and even for our long-term friend India. In case a total defeat of Daesh in Syria and Iraq, the most vulnerable Central Asia states, in order of their proneness to radical Islamism, according to Russian views, are, first place, Tajikistan, second place, Kyrgyzstan, third place, Turkmenistan, fourth place, Uzbekistan, and at the last place, Kazakhstan, which has a very stable economy, the most stable economy, actually, among all Central Asia states, and the most developed country among the Central Asian states. And moreover, Kazakhstan has never been under the acute influence of radical Islamism among all Central Asian states. What are the Russia's views and measures on how to combat radical Islamism in Central Asia? Russia is now making serious efforts to combat radical Islamism emanating from Afghanistan via Central Asia and threatening Russia's national security interests not only at its border with Central Asia states, but also in Central Asia in trying to actively involve, for this purpose, Collective Security Treaty Organization, CSTO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization, and other key outside actors such as India, Iran, Pakistan, and China. And according to Russia's views, the looming threat of Daesh terror activities in Afghanistan and Central Asian states can only be coped with the collective effort with all external parties concerned. Even Russia is suggesting cooperation with the United States and European Union countries who have their own interests in Central Asia on that matter. And now I'm just finally going to the conclusion of my short presentation. Russia is vitally interested in fighting Islamic radicalism in Central Asia. Its further spread is linked to the potential growth of many cross-border threats: terrorism, drug trafficking, uncontrolled migration, etc. In the migration context, the security of Russia's metropolitan areas, above all Moscow, by the way, largely depends on where Russia and the entire international community will be able to render effective support to Central Asian countries in countering the growing threat of radical Islamism. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your attention.